Well, welcome back. Man, it's been a whole week. And once again, I really do miss you all. But you know what would really make me have such a really good day? Is a nice big old hug. When I get the very next chance, I can't wait to give you all such a big hug. So parents, please remember that if you want to stay up to date on all the things that we're doing, then please send a text message using the @NZACCP to the number 81010. This way you can get all the regular updates and information that we have going out to all of our students. This includes arts, projects, and different activities, and even opportunities to be on our Children's Church broadcast. Now, if you would like to be a volunteer and help us with the broadcast, maybe be on the show as well, then please send the @MZACHI to the number 81010.
Hi, my name is Kiana Haygood, and here are the announcements. Follow us at Capital MTZ Today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. Like and follow us to stay up to date and get notifications when we go live. Now it's seed time and harvest. For Children's Church, we ask that every child gives $1. This helps them learn about the blessings and importance of giving. You can give to the church in these following ways. Number one, you can give by mailing your check, not cash, to Mount Zion Assemblies, P.O. Box 7675, Fresno, California 93747. Number two, next you can text the word GIVE to 833-668-2664. That's the word GIVE to 833-668-2664. Then follow the prompts to ensure your donation is set up correctly. Next, you can use the Cash App by typing $MTZ Assemblies. In the notes section, you can type offerings plus Children's Church. I hope you have a great day. God bless you.
All right, here's one of my favorite parts of our broadcast. It's our story time. So, are you ready? Well, guess what you're gonna need? We're gonna need our Bibles, a pencil, color pencils, or markers, paper. Put all your papers either in a binder or in the same folder or notebook. This way, you can always keep track of it. Take note to write down all the questions and the answers. Let's make sure that you're putting on your thinking caps. Good. And then we're going to use our listening ears. Good. And we're going to use our watchful eyes. And by using our watchful eyes, we're going to pay attention and we're going to make sure that we're following along.
While it's still dark, the tomb is open. Mary goes to the tomb, sees the open tomb, then runs to Peter and another disciple. Peter and the other disciple run to the tomb. The other disciple reaches the tomb first. The other disciple saw the linen folded inside the tomb, they looked inside but still didn't understand that Jesus must rise from the dead. And they went home.
Dear woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for?
Mary thought he was a gardener and said,
Sir, have you taken him away? Tell me where you put him and I'll go get him.
Mary!
Rabbi.
Which means teacher. And Mary told the disciples the message Jesus gave her. Later that night, the disciples were meeting and the door was shut and locked because they were afraid of Jewish leaders when suddenly,
I told you.
He is a hard fixer.
I hope that story really touched your heart and got you thinking about how much God loves you and how much God loves His people. If you want a closer relationship with God or to know the God that we learn about each and every week from the Bible, then say this prayer with me. Say, "Dear God, I believe that Jesus Christ died for my sins. And I believe that God raised Him from the dead. I ask You now to come into my heart and save me. Thank You, Lord, for saving me. Amen." And just by doing that, right now there's angels shouting, rejoicing, playing music. They're excited, fireworks are blasting, everybody's having a wonderful time because you have made the best decision of your entire life. God is proud of you, and I'm so proud of you. And guess what? You don't have to do this alone. Please contact the church. Please email us, call us. Make sure that you reach out so that we can help you on this journey in life. You don't have to do it alone. You don't have to learn alone. You are now a part of a huge, gigantic, wonderful family that loves you.